In this screencast, I'm going to show you how to use the bisection method in VBA to solve complicated equations involving one variable. This spherical tank is a metallic tank, and we want to know the volume as a function of fluid height in this glass tube. The equation for this looks something like this. We are trying to set this equation equal to zero. If we know volume, we know radius of this tank, we can solve for the height corresponding to that, where height is just the height in this tube of the liquid. What we want to do is set up a flow diagram. What we're actually trying to do is create a function here. I'm going to call it spherical tank. And we want to be able to, in Excel, put this formula into a cell, and we're going to give it inputs A and B, and then we're going to give it a volume and radius. So these are the arguments of our function, where A is the lower initial bound of bisection and B is the upper initial bound. The output is going to be the height. We're going to start, and the user is going to input the function A, B, V, and R. The next thing that's going to happen is I'm going to first start out with a low. A low value is going to equal A. A and B are in feet, and H's are all going to be in meters. Similarly, V is going to be in gallons, so we're going to have to make the conversion to cubic meters in our code at some point. We're going to say radius is in feet, H high is going to be equal to B, and then we're going to define an H mid as the average, so that's just A plus B divided by 2. So these are calculations that we're going to be doing in our code. Bisection method uses a lot of iteration, so you're doing the bisection method quite a few times. And we're going to just say for this example, and this is something that can be changed, we're going to do 20 iterations of the bisection method. We have a count controlled loop because we're doing this a fixed number of times. There are other ways to do this, but I'm going to do a for next loop. We start out with I equals 1. The increment is going to be I equals I plus 1. And then we're going until I is greater than 20. So if I is greater than 20, we're going to exit the loop. If I is less than 20 or equal to 20, then we're going to do another iteration of the bisection technique. We start out the bisection technique. The way to determine if the zero is in an interval is by looking at the function values. So for example, here, we know that the zero has to be in this region because f of x at the lower bound times f of x at the high bound is a negative number. We're going to actually put in here a conditional. Is f of h low times f of h mid is less than zero, then the solution has to be between h low and h high. If that's true, we want to keep the same h low, but then we want to redefine h high as the old midpoint. That's false. Then we actually do the opposite, where we're going to say that h low is now equal to h mid. And then after we do both of those, we're going to come back together. And regardless of both those pathways, there's one more thing that we need to do, and that's to redefine the new H-mid, which is just the average of low and high. So now we've redefined that. This is a single iteration of the bisection method, and then when we're done with that, we actually go all the way back here. We increment our I by one more, so now I is going to be 2. Is 2 greater than 20? No, we're going to keep going. And we're going to do this 20 times, and we're doing the bisection method and zooming in on the actual root of our equation. Now, the one thing you may be wondering is, in here, we have our function. So how would you actually do that in VBA code? We're going to outsource this calculation of the function values to another function, and this other function will be called solve function, and it'll be its own separate function. And I think you'll see more what I mean in a few moments. The only thing we have left of our flowchart is the output. Once we've done those 20 iterations, we would like it to display an actual height. H low, H high, and H mid are all going to approach the same value. We are done. Let's take a look at this in the code in VBA. What you see here, I've named this function spherical tank, and I've got A, B, V, and R as inputs. And I just put some comments here, and comments you can denote with an apostrophe. A and B are in feet, R is in feet, and V is in gallons, which is, this is going to be pretty important, because lower down, we're defining H low as the initial A, so A is going to be in feet, and we're converting to meters. So we've done that with H high. We've also done that down here with radius. We have our for next loop here. If solve function, this is where we're using these function values. So we're using a function within a function. And we look down here, I've defined another function, solve function, and that's just the function that we're trying to zero. If we scroll over here, you see that I've used application worksheet function pi. If that function at the low bound times the function value at the midpoint, if that product is negative, then we know that the zero has to lie somewhere in that range, and then this is where we do the conditional changes, where we now say h high is the h midpoint. We recalculate a new h mid, otherwise h low is the new mid, and then we can keep going, and you see I have 20 iterations. We end that with a next I. I've also dimmed I up here as an integer. The only thing left is the output, so the output of a function is the function name. We have spherical tank, and I'm just converting it to feet here. One more thing I forgot to mention is volume is in gallons that they input into the function, and down here in my solve function, I'm actually converting volume to cubic meters by using a conversion factor. If we go back to Excel, I put in a bunch of different values of volume, and now I can just type in here spherical tank, and I'm putting in A and B, so I'm going to use 0 and 20. Again, this is in feet. The next argument is volume, so I'm just going to reference this cell, and then we have radius at the end, and I've already named cell C2 radius. And when I press enter, it automatically goes through the bisection technique. It went through 20 iterations, and I can copy this down and fill everything in. Let me just real quickly summarize what we did. We first set up a flowchart. This process is going through the iteration bisection 20 different times. If that's true, then we redefine high as the mid, and we recalculate H mid. If that's false, H low is a mid, and we keep going, and at the end of this we display H mid. We're taking advantage of another function, so a function within a function. If we look back at the code, again, we're using our main function is spherical tank, but we are using another function, and this is the function that we're trying to zero.